Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we'll be studying chapter Biochemistry of Cell. In that, we'll be studying DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. DNA is your genetic material and my genetic material. It is because of DNA that two different individuals look different from each other. DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. Now, whenever you see, you will never find one individual similar to another individual on planet Earth. The reason is DNA, your genetic material and my genetic material. DNA is present inside our cells, precisely inside nucleus. Now, the structure of DNA was discovered by Watson and Crick. DNA is double-stranded. When I say double-stranded, it means single strand and single strand. DNA is helical. Helical, if you have to do, take a rubber band and just twist it. When you twist a rubber band, the structure that you get is the structure of DNA, helical structure. DNA stores genetic information. For example, the color of your eyes is black or your hairs are curly. The reason is your DNA. Your sister might have straight hairs and you might have curly hairs. The reason is mixing and matching of DNA. Now, DNA is antiparallel. Means when you take two strands of DNA, the two strands of DNA run 5 prime to 3 prime and 3 prime to 5 prime. DNA is complementary. The bases of DNA, for example, adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine, they both are complementary to each other. When I say complementary, it means they attach to their similar partners. For example, adenine will always combine with thymine and guanine will combine with cytosine. The bond between adenine and thymine is double bond, whereas between guanine and cytosine, it is triple bond. DNA has a ribosugar attached to it. Along with ribosugar, there is a phosphate group attached to DNA. This phosphate group forms the backbone of DNA. Now, the basis of the DNA, which we're talking about, A, T, G, C. Now, we categorize this basis of DNA into purines and pyrimidines. When I say purines, these are separate, and pyrimidines, these are separate things. DNA undergoes a process called as replication. DNA, when we inherit, half of the DNA is inherited, or the DNA is formed in the form of chromosomes. So when I take a cell, break a cell, we get nucleus. Inside nucleus, you'll get chromosomes. And when you enlarge a big number of chromosomes, what you get is your DNA. DNA is a very big molecule. DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. Now, DNA was discovered by two scientists. Their name was Watson and Crick. They discovered that DNA was helical or it was coiled. DNA basically stores your genetic information. The way you look, the way your hairs are, the way your skin color is, everything is decided by DNA. And half of the DNA you get from your parents. That is, half is from mother and half is from father. DNA is basically a double-stranded, two-stranded, antiparallel, means it runs 5 prime to 3 prime, and complementary molecule. Bases of the DNA are A, T, G, and C. A is adenine, T is thymine, G is guanine, and C is cytosine. Now, there is complementarity between the bases. For example, A always pairs with T and G always pairs with C. There is a ribose sugar. When I say ribose sugar, it means a pentose sugar, which provides DNA its energy source. For example, when you eat food, you get your energy. Similarly, when DNA has to do work, it reads ribose sugar or pentose sugar. Phosphate, or you can say the backbone of DNA. As your spinal cord, if the spinal cord is not present, you cannot walk erect or stand erect. Similarly, phosphate forms the backbone of DNA. These are the materials that are present inside DNA. The structure of DNA is something like this. It is basically double-stranded. That is one strand, second strand. It runs anti-parallel. When I say anti-parallel, it means 5 prime to 3 prime and 5 prime to 3 prime. Look, they are anti-parallel to each other or opposites to each other. The bases are complementary. A pairs with T and G pairs with C. Between A and T, there is a double bond. Between G and C, there is a triple bond. And these bonds are nothing but hydrogen bonds. And we all know that it is very easy to break hydrogen bonds. The most easiest bonds to break in chemistry or in biology. Now, along with this, DNA has ribose sugar or pentose sugar. Phosphates, its backbone. So this was students' DNA or deoxyribose nucleic acid. I hope that somewhere you all are clear what DNA is and how DNA works. Now in the later part of the chapters, we'll study what DNA does and what is the reason that DNA is like this. Thank you.